All right, you should know the drill by now. This is another molten salt electrolysis video where we try to extract reactive metals by electrolysis procedures. If you don't know the drill, I would recommend going to check out one of my other videos on the topic. Hopefully I will have linked them somehow, or maybe if I remember, put them in a playlist. Anyway, quick overview. Today's experiment is trying to make potassium metal, the most reactive metal in the molten salt electrolysis series so far. I don't like to waste people's time though. I've already done the experiment and I'll let you know now it didn't end up working. Additionally, the quality of my filming, especially the audio quality later on, really wasn't all that great. So click away now if you feel like it. I've still put all the footage together and uploaded it here because it was rather interesting and we did get quite close to making potassium metal. If we look all the way back to a previous video where we made sodium metal, that was a simple enough procedure involving the electrolysis of molten sodium hydroxide. A lot of people in the comments of that video asked a very reasonable question. Does the same kind of process work for making potassium metal? Can we electrolyze molten potassium hydroxide instead to make potassium? As it turns out, it doesn't quite work like that because potassium metal is significantly soluble in molten potassium hydroxide, preventing you from being able to extract it. So I decided to do a little bit of digging. I mean, it must be possible to make potassium metal by electrolysis in some way, because that was how it was originally isolated as a metal. In my digging, I found a couple of past industrial procedures that seemed to use a eutectic mixture of potassium hydroxide, potassium carbonate, and potassium chloride in varying mixtures. And apparently, as far as I could tell, that seemed to reduce the solubility problem of potassium metal in the melt. Information is kind of limited in this regard, so I'm not exactly certain of these findings, but potassium salts are really easy to get, so I thought it was pretty stupid not to try it. So, as you'll see in a minute, I tried melting down the relevant mixture of potassium hydroxide, carbonate, and chloride. If it worked and we were able to electrolyze it, we expected the cathode, I used a nickel strip, to reduce potassium ions into potassium metal, which we could collect, hopefully. And then the anode, which was a carbon rod in my case, would oxidize hydroxide ions into water and oxygen, or chloride ions into chloride, or maybe hydroxide ions and the carbon in the electrode into carbon dioxide and water, something like that. A whole mess of the three, possibly. I don't think we need much more detail than that, so I think now we'll just skip backwards in time a little bit to when I was actually doing the experiment. Actually, one last thing, I'd like to preemptively apologize for my choice of crucible in this experiment. I used the same stainless steel measuring cup that I've used in past molten salt electrolysis experiments. People have repeatedly told me that it's not a good idea, it kind of degrades over time and contaminates the stuff I'm trying to melt. I think I learned my lesson here. It went pretty badly this time. I won't be using stainless steel as a crucible again, I promise.
Simple as this, really. We've got all of our potassium salts in the stainless steel crucible, slowly melting, and as soon as that's all done, and all of the water content that was in the potassium hydroxide has kind of boiled out, I will stick the electrodes in, and we will start electrolyzing it. The melt seems to have calmed down at this point. We've got everything molten. I think most of the water has boiled out of there. I've also put the electrodes into the melt ready to electrolyze, and I've set my power supply to 8 amps. So if I head over here and turn things on, we should see a whole bunch of electrolysis. Now, if we remember what happened back when we did our sodium electrolysis, we'll recall that the initial stages of electrolysis didn't really lead to the formation of sodium. We kind of just electrolyzed what I assume was trace amounts of water in the sodium hydroxide melt. And I believe that's probably what's going to happen first here when we're doing the same thing for potassium. I think we're going to have to be very patient. If we see potassium, that's great, and if we don't, then I suppose we'd never really expected this to work very well anyway. About half an hour into electrolysis, Okay, we've had it running at exactly 8 amps that whole time. The voltage has hovered around 6 volts for that time as well. You can see we've now finally kind of electrolyzed away, I assume, all of the water that was present in our potassium hydroxide initially. We can tell that because there's a whole lot less bubbling coming off the cathode. Additionally, now that the water electrolysis has kind of cooled off, we are actually starting to see bits of potassium, I think, form around the cathode. I don't know if you can see right down in there, but just every now and again, we start to see some very shiny metal appear on the surface of the potassium hydroxide melt. Now, quite often it goes pop and kind of bursts into flame, but I think we might just right now be getting to the point where we can actually see some very nice potassium metal forming on the cathode. I swear the lighting is not good for this kind of experiment. I don't really know what's happening. I can see the potassium down there. It's so shiny. I just can't figure out how to collect it. I'm using this little scooper, trying to scoop it out, but every time I think I get some, it just disappears. So I'm thinking maybe it is just kind of dissolving into the melt. That'd be disappointing because it's right there. Or maybe it's reacting with the air. I think you can even see little wisps of smoke come off the cell every now and again. Anyway, I'm going to continue trying to extract the potassium from this cell because, as I said before, I can see it forming, and maybe you can see that on camera as well. It'll show up better as soon as the shadow comes back over the entire cell. All right, I officially give up. Even though I can see the potassium forming, and I think at this point you can too, just those shiny bits that pop up around the cathode there, I cannot extract it. I've been trying for a solid half an hour now and I haven't got a single crumb of potassium out of this cell. It is either dissolving away into the melt as quickly as it forms, or it's reacting with the air. Either way, we were very close, but no cigar. I mean, technically we can still say that we did actually make potassium metal in this video. We just made it and then it disappeared very, very quickly. I am going to leave that there though. We will have to revisit potassium metal generation in a future video. Maybe once we've come up with some way of fixing the problem of potassium dissolving in the melt or reacting with the air. Tricky problem to solve, but I don't know. Maybe we'll figure something out. Another thing, actually, the potassium hydroxide in the stainless steel actually kind of ate through the crucible to some degree. I didn't really notice it happening as it was running, but if we actually have a look down into the furnace, probably can't see very well. There's a whole bunch of potassium hydroxide that has melted through and is now sitting at the bottom of the furnace, which is really bad. I think that maybe has broken the furnace, or maybe it's not broken it, but I don't think this is going to be very usable in the future. So a bit of a disaster of an experiment, but no matter, we will come back to it one day and figure things out. I don't know why I insist on using the stainless steel as a crucible for these experiments. It's probably a really, really bad choice. I need to figure something else out. Anyway, whatever.
Well, that's that. No potassium for us. I think it was kind of frustrating to see the potassium floating there, not being able to collect it, but I'm still pretty happy that we came this close. We were able to see potassium metal, which is better than nothing. I will be trying to make potassium metal again at some stage, by electrolysis, of course. I don't care about any of the other methods. I've got two ideas for making it work. First of all, I've done a bit more digging and I found that molten potassium hydroxide can be electrolyzed to give potassium metal under some conditions. And these conditions are a much more complicated cell where we exclude atmospheric oxygen and also limit the rate of dissolved potassium in the melt from diffusing through the liquid mass. My second idea, I might not actually talk about for the moment. Both of these ideas require a fair bit of thinking, so it's going to be a long wait before we give them a go. But in the meantime, there are a bunch more metals that we can try to make by molten salt electrolysis. So until then, I'll see you later.